In America, drugs kill 50,000 people a year. The CDC now labels the trend epidemic as drug overdose deaths rise year after year. Prescription pain pills and heroin are the top killers, stealing more lives than car crashes. America has a serious problem with drug addiction.
We're a pharma-dependent nation, and it's ludicrous, and we're letting that ruin our lives.
But a growing number of opioid addicts and chronic pain patients are turning to a plant called kratom to get off the pills.
The first time I tried kratom has been the very last time I've ever taken a pain pill since 2010, I can proudly testify.
We're not druggies. We're not looking for a high. We're looking for pain relief.
Native to Southeast Asia in the same family as the coffee plant, kratom, they say, is changing their lives.
I say it all the time. It saved my life.
Justine Kosar lives in Midwest City. She has fibromyalgia, carpal tunnel, degenerative discs in her back, nerve impingement, migraine headaches, and depression. She lives in pain, constant, debilitating, excruciating pain.
You feel like you can't go on, and I have to choose. I have to choose to go on.
Justine has spent the better part of two decades on prescription painkillers.
Darvocet, fentanyl, oxycodone, hydrocodone, which are Percocet, Loratab, and Norco. Oh, morphine. I forgot morphine. Morphine.
Justine is not an addict. Her lifelong cocktail of narcotics has always been prescribed by a doctor. But that pharmaceutical relief comes with terrible side effects.
I've had to absolutely change my entire lifestyle.
Justine heard about kratom from a friend. She buys this dry leaf powder online and then mixes it into tea in the mornings and capsules in the afternoons.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
And her pain is gone. She's almost completely off pain meds, down 75% from what she used to take.
Maybe the best alternative that we have at this point, that mankind has, to opiate addiction and for treatment for people who live with chronic pain.
But some say kratom kills. The U.S. Drug Enforcement Agency tracks overdose statistics. They blame kratom for more than a dozen deaths, including 36-year-old Guy Garcia.
And we know that it was the kratom.
Over the summer, the DEA cracked down on kratom, announcing the agency would classify the herb as a Schedule 1 controlled substance. Schedule 1, that's in the company of heroin, LSD, and ecstasy.
And some of the people literally described it was like I just took a fistful of painkillers. It just sent them into this powerful relaxation. Just their problems are over, the concerns are gone. And just a very euphoric feeling.
The Oklahoma Bureau of Narcotics considered a statewide ban a few years ago, but they've had just one citizen complaint, and generally kratom hasn't been a major problem in Oklahoma.
We held off because we said we at least want to watch it, and if this starts to become a problem, we would go back to our legislature and deal with it.
Stop the ban! Stop the ban on kratom!
When the DEA announced an emergency federal ban, the kratom world exploded with anger and frustration. United on YouTube and in person, rallying around the country, they begged legislators to reason with the DEA.
To stop having to go to the damn drugstores and get their bags full of expensive prescriptions.
I am a fully functioning, active, productive member of this society today, and I am heartbroken and devastated that it's going to be taken away from us.
If you're damn short-sighted enough to make something illegal that helps so many people, you really haven't thought it through.
Kratom found support in Congress. More than 50 lawmakers penned a letter to the agency to take a step back. And it worked. The DEA backed off their deadline. Now they are asking for public input before they decide how to proceed.
In my mind, it's a little bit ridiculous because a human being growing a plant and harvesting it and using it for medicine is basically one of the most natural things that we can do. And for the government to come in and outlaw that is really absurd. And to try to enforce that is even more absurd. And then when we start putting people in prison for it or punishing them for it, it becomes cruelly absurd.
In Oklahoma, it's actually kind of hard to come by. We found just one retailer in South OKC, Little House of Kratom.
Probably gonna be changing the name soon.
Yeah, I guess. I gotta
talk to the advertising people about some major changes.
Blaine Novak is watching the news for word about the ban. He'll trash his stash if it goes into effect. If it happens, he thinks his customers will go back to heroin or pain pills.
They will go back to bad habits because they can't get the thing that was helping them stay away from it, you know?
The DEA is now listening as Kratom users organize, doubling down on their claims that this mysterious Far Eastern herb is the answer for helping millions get off and stay off addictive drugs. Allie Meyer, News Channel 4.